Dear learner, welcome to my science class. Today's our topic is energy flow in an ecosystem. So energy flow in ecosystem, it is related to the content which is present in an ecosystem. So you all know that first topic we taken first, that is what is ecosystem. Ecosystem means the factors in previous class you also know that what is ecosystem. Some topic it is given in your 8th class. Now in your 9th class you study what is ecosystem. In the ecosystem there is present living and non-living thing. So living and non-living thing are which are that things. So living things means all animals and plants. Okay. Now what is non-living thing? It is the factors required for development of living thing. You all understand that living thing which is present in an ecosystem, it is animal and plants, and non-living things are the factors required for the growth development of the living thing. Understood? So this is the ecosystem. Now energy flow and ecosystem, in previous video I say that there are the factors which are present in an ecosystem. So what are that factor? First one, that is a that is known as a producer, that is a autotroph. Second one, that is a consumer. That consumer, it is having I give four types of consumer. It is a primary consumer. Second one, secondary. Nantar there is present apex consumer. Okay, so that are the consumer which is found in the that is found in the ecosystem. Now that energy that all consumer and producer, whenever present in an ecosystem, they can give effect to each other. They can impact on each other. So what type of impact? Whenever producer can produce food, producer can produce their own food. So that food are consumed by primary consumers. Food is consumed by primary consumer. Okay. So that primary consumer, whenever directly depend on the consumer, that is directly depend on the producer, so it is known as herbivorous. So that herbivorous can take the energy, from the primary, taken energy from the producer. Understood? Means that energy which is present inside the producer, it is go inside the herbivorous. Now whenever this herbivorous eaten by secondary consumer, it is known as a that means that herbivorous, it is eaten by the secondary consumer. That secondary consumer, it is known as a carnivorous. That carnivorous, it is having the characteristic that can eaten by herbivorous, the energy which is present inside the body of herbivorous, it is go inside the carnivorous. Now this carnivorous, it is whenever eaten by the apex consumer, that it is also known as carnivorous. That carnivorous, whenever eaten by this carnivorous, the energy which is present inside the secondary consumer is go inside the body of consumer. It is the apex consumer. Now what type of energy flow it can be carried out? There is another one, that is omnivorous. That omnivorous which can eat plant and flesh. Plant and flesh means that fleshes and plant, both energy means producer energy and there is a carnivorous energy, that both energy are consumed inside the body of omnivorous. Understood? Now there is a one decomposer. That decomposer can take the energy, all these whenever it is died. means the dead body which is present inside the body of is the dead body which is present in the on the or on the surface. The decomposer whenever come or decomposer whenever present, that can take the energy which is present inside the dead body. Okay, so it is also one of the type of consumer, but that consumer it is saprophyte. It is known as a saprophytes. Mean that saprophytes can take that type of energy and consume there. Understood? So in this way, this is the energy flow. Means that is the energy which is produced by producer, that is go inside the consumer, primary, secondary and tertiary or apex consumer. And this omnivorous, it is take energy from the producer and also from the that is known as a consumer, that is primary, secondary or maybe tertiary. Now this decomposer also take energy from this energy flow. So in this way, this energy flow, it is carried out by different level of a living thing. Now next point, it is given the food chain. Now this next point we give in the ecosystem food chain. So what type of ecosystem food chain is found in the surrounding? Large number of food chain we see. Now ecosystem, it is presently say that ecosystem, it is presently say that there is present a biotic and biotic means living and abiotic means non-living. Okay, means living ecosystem, it is formed whenever there is present living and non-living thing. Understood? Means living and non-living thing whenever come in contact with each other or can give impact to each other, then ecosystem it can be formed. So that ecosystem which is present there, that can have biotic and abiotic factors. Understood? So that biotic and abiotic factor whenever can impact to each other or can depend to each other, then there is formation of a food chain. Understood? So first one, that is a producer. First one, that is a producer. It is the starting point of the food chain, because it is produce. It can produce. Understood? Now there is a consumer. There is second one, that is a consumer. Maybe it is a consumer. That consumer maybe that consume directly from the producer. That consume energy directly from the producer, or it can be consumed by primary, secondary, tertiary. So it is primary, secondary, or tertiary or apex. So now this consumer, it is whenever diet, it can decompose. Decomposer, or it is known as a saprophytes. Okay, so these saprophytes, this is the chain which is found here. Means producer can give energy, producer can produce, consumer can consume, and decompose, it can totally finish. Understood? So what type of flow of energy it is carry out? So we take one of the example. That is a grasshopper. Grasshopper, it is the insect which is present on the grass. Means it is totally depend on the grasses producer. It is totally depend on the grasses. So it can take the food from grass. Means producer is grass, depend on that, this grasshopper can take energy. Understood? Now this grasshopper, it is eaten by frog. This grasshopper is eaten by frog. It is a consumer. Now this frog is eaten by the snake. Now this snake, it is eaten by eagle. Okay, means this vulture or eagle, this eagle can eat the body of the snake. It is topmost, and whenever vulture can be died, the saprophyte or decomposer is there that can totally finish the body. Means the decomposer can decompose the body, and the soil or nutrition or maybe present there, all it is give to the producer. Okay, means the rotation of this type of material exchange और एनर्जी एक्सचेंज इट कैन बी कैरी आउट कंटिन्यूअसली एंड इट इज नोन एज फूड चेन बिकॉज ऑल इज फॉर द फूड. ऑल इज फॉर द फूड मीन्स इट इज ऑल्सो ईट ग्रासेस बिकॉज ऑफ इट इज द फूड ऑफ ग्रासहॉपर. फ्रॉग ईट टू द ग्रासहॉपर बिकॉज द फूड ऑफ फ्रॉग इज ग्रासहॉपर. स्नेक ईटन बाय ईटन स्नेक ईट फ्रॉग बिकॉज फ्रॉग इज द फूड ऑफ स्नेक. नाउ वल्चर ईट स्नेक बिकॉज द फूड ऑफ वल्चर इज स्नेक एंड द वल्चर वेन एवर डाइट द बॉडी ऑफ दैट वल्चर इट इज डीकम्पोज बिकॉज डीकम्पोजर इट इज टेकन द न्यूट्रिशन ऑफ द इटसेल्फ फॉर इटसेल्फ इट इज फ्रॉम द वल्चर बॉडी एंड होल बॉडी ऑफ वल्चर वेन एवर रिमूविंग द सॉइल विच इज प्रिपेयर इट इज गो टू द ग्रासेस और ग्रीन प्लांट. Understood. So it is called a food chain. Now there is a only one chain it is carried out there. No, there are lots of chains. Suppose this grasshopper it is eaten. Grasshopper it is eaten by another. It is not frog. It is by a sparrow. It is eaten by a sparrow. Now this sparrow it is eaten by a snake. Whenever it is eaten by vulture, whenever the vulture body it is decomposing, so it is another one. Now grasshopper it is not there, so another one which is present, there is a deer. Deer it is one of the animal which is eaten by grasses. From this the body of deer it is eaten by tiger. The body of tiger it is eaten by lion. The body whenever died, the body of this lion it is decomposed by decomposer. The body of that decomposer it is converted into soil and give to the grasses. So what type of chain is there? Means 1, 2, 3. This type of chain is formed in one compact or it is one ecosystem. Then it is known as food web. Okay. So it is the concept that can I give here. There is an energy flow that is anu. It is the flow of energy flow of an ecosystem. It is first concept I give here. There is a food chain and the second one that is a food web. So you all understood in this time and we stop here. Thank you.